taught me to breathe underwater. Really, he did. When I was about 3 months old, my father started teaching me to swim. He put my face in the water, told me to blow bubbles. It caught on to that pattern rather quickly. And by the time I was 9 months old, my father stopped holding me by my belly after having taught me to swim. Arm over arm, take a breath, blow bubbles, arm over arm, at 9 months old. As a child, I grew up swimming with a community swim team. I won trophies and prizes. I became a champion swimmer. In high school, I set records, and two of those records stand today. When I was about 8 years old, my father and my grandfather, who were both builders, were building a house about a block away. I was the first girl in four generations on my father's side of the family. I had three older brothers. My father made a decision when I was very young that there would be nothing my brothers could do that I couldn't do, except maybe pee standing up, which I learned how to do anyway. I learned how to swim at an early age. When I was eight, I learned how to put the cabinet hardware on the house that was being finished with the proper tools. When I was 10, I helped frame a house with a power nail gun. My father was a bit of a visionary. Late 1960s, he saw things changing for the roles of women. He saw things changing around him. His friends were getting divorced. Their ex-wives were going to work. My father always said to me, it's important for a woman to have something to fall back on. Fall back on. Fall back. Isn't that what we do when we change the clocks back in November to end a daylight savings time? I had no idea what this man was talking about. I was very close to my dad, and yet for some reason I never asked him, what does this mean, fall back? And while his buddies' ex-wives were going to work, my mother, who was divorced from my father, was laying on the couch all day. She had no marketable skills. She had very little capability to communicate well. She was poorly organized, and she had nothing to fall back on. When I was about 12 years old, my father bought me a typewriter. Yes, I am that old, and he taught me to type. Because a woman needs to have something to fall back on. What? I need to learn how to type so I have something to fall back on? What does this mean? I had no idea. But what I did know that I was 16 and got my first paying job, which was teaching water safety to kids at camp. Ooh, I had a marketable skill. When I was 18, I went to work in a doctor's office doing insurance billing, and for that, I needed to know how to type. Ooh. I had a marketable skill. I was starting to catch on to this fallback idea, but what was my father really doing? Because I was going to go to college and medical school. I was going to have this big career. What would I need to fall back from? Was my father setting me up for failure? Is that what he was teaching me all these little skills for? When I was 18, I bought my first car. My father taught me how to change a tire on the side of the freeway, how how to change my own oil. Because a woman needs to have something to fall back on. And I was starting to catch on. And yet, it still did not mesh. I was going to have this great career. I was on my way to college. I was going to go to medical school. What was I going to fall back from? When I was 35, I built the first child safety fence around our swimming pool when I had an infant son and we bought a new home. Because I knew how to do that. And when I was in my 40s and my girlfriends were complaining that their boyfriends were using them for punching bags, I recalled my skills from my father teaching me how to box. And I taught my girlfriends self-defense. Fall back. I was starting to understand what this concept of falling back actually meant. And when I was in my mid-50s and my husband died, my business partner, my best friend, and the person I've always relied on for strength and courage was gone. I didn't have the heart when I got my head back on straight to go back into the business we shared. I just didn't have it in me. I took a job with an electrical engineer where I needed to use skills of office management, typing, communication, far from medical school. I had something to fall back on. My father had set me up to fall back so I could move forward. Mr. Pelz.